Hey everyone, this is Mukesh Otwani once again from learn-innovation.com. So guys, today in this video we'll talk about how you can execute your JMeter script from the command line, or I will say in the non-GUI mode. Okay, the moment you open our JMeter command prompt, so this is how we started our JMeter, right? So the moment you start your JMeter, if you just notice here, they have mentioned here that don't use GUI mode for load testing. Basically it is only for test creation and test debugging, which means what we did so far, we created our samples, right? Then we have added the listeners, we have added user defined variables, and we have analyzed the result, right? So you can use this GUI mode only for test creation debugging. But once your tests are done, once your everything is set, you have set the user, ramp up everything, in ideal situation you need to run always the test from the GUI mode, from the non-GUI mode, which is a CLI mode. Okay, so this is what exactly we are going to do. And this is what they have mentioned, that we need to use JMeter. Then you have to use these flags, and then you can, you know, run your JMeter test. You can also get your reports as well. Fine. So first of all, let me explain you these flags, okay? Because one way is just copy this command and run it. That is one of the way. Okay. Suppose if I copy this, so you can see I have one flag called -n -t. Then you need to provide the path of this JMX file, -l, which is for logs. Where do you want to save the logs? And finally, you have to give the -e, which is for HTML report, and -o for output. So what exactly these flags are, we'll see one by one. So let's do one thing. Let's first of all run this command and let's see whether it's generating our result or not. Based on that, we will see. So first of all, we need this JMeter, right? Now, how you will find this JMeter? It's very easy. So if you have followed my previous videos, this is how we have installed, right? We downloaded this file, then we unzipped and we got this folder. In this folder, if you see, we have a bin folder, which is a binary, and here you will find JMeter, right? So this is the Windows batch command that we need to execute. And if you are following this on Mac or Linux, then you need to run jmeter.sh file, fine? That also we have dedicated video. So this is the .sh file, which is a shell script that you need to trigger. Right now I'm using Windows 10, so I will be using this JMeter. So you just open a command prompt. Okay, let's open the command prompt and let's navigate till this directory. So I will simply do the control C. I will just type cd and hit enter. Just paste it and hit enter. Right now you can see it's not navigating, still it is focusing on the old one. So I will say press E colon. So now you can see right now we are in this bin directory. So if I simply pass this JMeter, and let's see, I will just say -?. The moment you hit enter, okay, you will be getting couple of flags that you can use it. So basically you can see whatever flags is available inside JMeter, you can see all these flags are available. Again, you don't have to use all of them. I will show you which one we have to use, which is required for the time being. So whatever we have seen this, right, -n, which is for non-GUI mode, and -t, which is for the path of this JMX file, it is all. So let's do one thing. Let's first of all, just a second, yeah, this one only. I will do a cls so that we should not get the previous one. Now we'll just type JMeter -n, which is for non-GUI mode, -t. -t means we need to provide the location of the JMX file, which is actually T means test plan link. So this is the test plan that we have created, right? Apache JMeter. And if you see, it is stored under this directory, right? So this is the directory that, where we have our JMX file, right? So in your case, you can save this JMX at any location. For my system, I stored with this name, firstjmeter.jmx file. Now what I can do, I can simply drag and drop, or I can give the path. So I can drag and drop directly and it has taken the path, fine. Now if you just go here, you will see right now we have 5 users. Let me just try with one user and I'm just saving this file, fine. Now let me simply run it from here, and you will see it will take few seconds and it will start. So can you see it is starting standalone test. So basically it started on 4445 port number. Total 3 requests has been sent. The reason, because we have 3 samplers, right? 3 requests basically. Sampler name is HTTP request, but we have sent 3 requests. And we got every detail, right? 0% error. And this is another summary of the result. Now the next part is how you get this as a report. Okay, so now if you come back here, just go to this manual, you will also see one option called hyphen L, okay, which is for the log file where exactly you want to save the results. So let's say I want to save all my results here. Okay, so I will create a new folder here and I will just say my, or I will say gmeter logs, or you can say sample logs, anything. So this is the directory where I want to store all my logs. So just copy this directory and let's use this hyphen L. Okay, so I will use again upper arrow and I will say hyphen L and I will provide the location. This is the location where I want to store all the logs. Let's say I want to store the log in .csv file. So I will just say let's say report 1, or you can give some other name. I'm just giving some random name, .csv. And let's do one thing, let's increase the number of users so that we should get some proper report. I will increase this to, let's say, 10 users. So 10 into 3, total 30 requests we will be getting, okay? And ramp up period is 5 seconds. So I have saved this using Control S, or you can simply save from here. Now let's run it once again. Okay, again it will take few seconds and then it will execute your test. And yes, finally it started and it is saying waiting for possible shutdown, all this condition shutdown, stop test now, heap dump, thread dumps, and so on. And finally it again executed and we got this summary as 30 request, correct? Now if you go back to this, it has created one report1.csv file. The moment you open this CSV file, okay, just click here and you can see you got the proper data. What is the response code, what is the response message, thread names, data type, success, failure message. Right now we don't have even a single failure and we got all these details, which includes your group thread, all threads, URL, latency, idle time, and so on. So how to read this report, as I mentioned, we will discuss one by one, but as of now you can see our tests are running in the background mode, or I will say non-GI mode or CLI mode. You are able to see all the reports. Right now it is in the CSV format, okay? Sometimes CSV reports are good for, you know, reading the data only on local system, but for better visualization we need to generate one HTML report so that you can see the graphs, right? You can also see the different things like 90 percentile, 95 percentile, 99, average time, deviations, and so on. So let's do one thing, let's save this file. Anyways, it's saved. Let me click on save. And now if you see the next part here, we need to also use hyphen E and hyphen O for path of the web report folder. So basically you don't need to write anything. You just need to use these two flags and you will be having the HTML report ready with you. So let's do one thing. I will show you two scenarios, okay? It's already saved. It is just formatting, I'm not saving it. For that, let me create another, okay? Because basically when you start working with HTML reports, you need a blank folder. So I will say JMeter HTML report 1. Okay, basically I will be storing all the HTML reports here, and the moment I come down here, again I will use upper arrow from the keyboard, it will get the same thing. Now I will say hyphen E hyphen O and then I will provide this path. So before we use this, let's search for hyphen E. So what exactly this hyphen E says? It will generate report dashboard after load test, and hyphen O means output folder for the report dashboard. Fine. Now let's hit enter, and what I want to do, I just want to generate a new CSV, report2.csv, and let me change this users to 20 this time. ramp up period, yeah, let's keep it 10 seconds. Okay, I'm saving this again. Let's go back here and hit enter. Okay, let's come to the end and then hit enter. Yeah, so basically once you understand how to run from the CLI mode, then yeah, it will be very easy. If you want to trigger this test from any Jenkins or I was any other CI server which you are using in your organization, right? You can also integrate this with your CI/CD pipeline and yeah, you'll get the results. So again, you can see we got error as, you know, 0%, total number of requests was 60, and this is end of run. So you can see, guys, basically we got this HTML file, right? Now here we have index.html file that you have to open. Just double click and it will open this report for you. So basically what we did, we tested only these three labels. So you can see now we also have some app decks. I will talk about this in detail in the next video when we read this report. So basically you can see the statistics, we got number of requests and we got four categories: the execution part, response time, throughput and the network. And if you come down here, it will also show you the errors in case if you have. Right now we don't have any errors, so it's all blank. And if you see here, we also have very intuitive chart here. So I will talk about this in the next video, okay? Very, very important part. But yeah, but the main motto of this video is just to show you how you can run from the command prompt. And yes, we are able to do it. That's all I have for this video, guys. So in case if you're new to this channel, then make sure you subscribe and like this video, share with your friends who are looking for performance testing tutorials. And if you any find, let me know and I will be happy to help you. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.